So using table J, the higher the element, the more reactive, the more likely it will be oxidized. The higher the element, the more likely it'll be oxidized. So again, I'm teaching a little different this year. Usually I get into some examples first, and then we talk about table J. I'm just telling you this up front this year, maybe it'll help a little bit. Let me explain why. All right. So let's look at the top three. What are the top three elements?
Li, Rb, and K.
Okay. And what are the bottom three?
Au, Ag, and Cu.
Okay.
All
right. What does oxidize mean? What has to happen to be oxidized? Lose electrons. Leo, lose electrons. You're oxidized. Okay. Where are these three metals on the periodic table? And there's a little one over there. Where are those three elements? What group? The left side, group one.
Yep.
Okay? So stay with me. This is going to help understand the overall concept. These three are in group one. These three are where?
Group 11?
Transition metals. They're towards
group
the 12. Middle. Okay? So these are group one, and then these are in the middle transition metals, okay? What have you learned about group one?
Most reactive.
Now, why do elements gain or lose electrons? What are they trying to achieve? Full valence shell, to be stable, right? So these three lose electrons much more readily than these three, okay? And again, with the connection I'm trying to make, is you've already learned group one is really reactive. Why is it really reactive? This is why. Because it likes to be they like to be oxidized. So all three of these like to get rid of an electron. They all like to lose an electron. Now if Li loses an electron or Rb loses an electron at K, they become Li plus one, Rb plus one, and K plus one. And as a result, they have a full valence shell. Lithium ends up with just two electrons, which is a full first level. Rb and K both end with eight. So when they lose that one electron, they become very stable. So that's why this statement makes sense. All right? So the further left on the chart really means the higher up on table J. So another way to understand this is the more reactive the metal, the better chance it's going to be oxidized. And one more thing, why that makes sense. If I want to make an ionic compound, NaCl, Na gives an electron to Cl. So Na becomes plus one, Cl becomes minus one. This is old news. This should make sense immediately. I hope so. So the reason this happens is actually because of electrochemistry. The Na likes to be oxidized, and the Cl is going to be reduced. So they work really well because they play pitch and catch with that electron. So I'm just trying to kind of connect things you've already learned to what you're learning now and how table J can help. So the more reactive it is, the higher on table J, the more likely it'll get rid of its electron to become stable, which means, now you know what that means, oxidized. All right? So the reason iron rusts is because it oxidizes. When iron rusts, it becomes more stable than just iron. It's iron plus two, Fe plus two. So when rust forms, Fe2O3, or FeO, either one, when rust forms, that's Fe plus three. That's actually good for iron. It's a good thing. We don't like rust, and it kind of looks like crap, and it kind of deteriorates the metal. All right, but the reason it does that is because the iron is being oxidized. Okay, it's losing electrons, and the oxygen's gaining. It's being reduced. So I'm starting here this year so that you can use table J to kind of help understand certain things. All right? What are those certain things? They're the practice problems I'm going to get into right now. All right? So I'm going to give you an example of how you're supposed to take this information and apply it. All right? So here we go. And you don't have any homework on this stuff today. You will do Wednesday. All right? So I'm going to give you a very simple reaction. Let's take magnesium solid and react it with oxygen gas. Alright, and we're going to make magnesium oxide solid. So a synthesis reaction. Okay, so you're going to take what we just talked about and we're going to apply it to this. and then we'll end with this. Okay, so we're gonna find, right, keep our eye on the ball, where the electrons are coming from and where they're going. Because this is ionic, so when they form a bond, somebody's losing, somebody's gaining electrons. Okay. Now, a little star underneath this. All elements and compounds have oxidation numbers of zero. You already know that, I'm just repeating that elements and compounds are neutral. Elements and compounds are neutral. You already knew that. So magnesium solid has a charge or oxidation number of zero. Oxygen has a charge or an oxidation number of zero. It's neutral. Okay, if I was holding a piece of magnesium, I wouldn't be getting zapped. I wouldn't be getting shocked because it's neutral. Only time you shock when things aren't neutral. Over here, MgO is zero, but in the compound, they use their charges. You guys remember what oxygen is? What's oxygen's charge in a compound?
Negative 2.
So if O is -2, what's Mg?
+2.
+2. Okay. So again, I'm going to repeat myself. This is an element. This is an element. They're not in compounds, and they're not dissolved in water. So therefore, they have zero charge. They are neutral. MgO is neutral, but they use their ions to bond. So in compounds, they have charges by themselves. It's another thing you'll hear me say, when they're by themselves, they're zero, no charge. Okay, all right, who brought their brain to school? Two questions for you guys. How many electrons are being transferred, and who's losing the electrons, and who's gaining? Think, don't say it. Mg and O2. One of them is getting rid of electrons, one of them is gaining when they form this bond, when they form that compound. So which one is losing electrons, oxidized, which one is gaining, reduced? And how many electrons are being transferred? So that's where I'm going to end today once I go over this quick. All right, you thought about it for a minute or so. Does anyone know which one of these is losing electrons and which one is gaining?
Mg is losing.
Yep, how do you know?
+2.
Good. Mg is losing electrons and becoming positive. If you lose a negative electron, you become positive. You already learned that. How do you know O is gaining?
-2.
Because it's becoming negative. Electrons are negative. Very good. How many electrons are being transferred?
2.
Very good. I hope everyone else is with Jake on that. We'll continue this tomorrow. That was a good little intro. Have a wonderful day.
Wait, when is the quiz due again?